typhoid fever isn't a disease that we come across much in the UK or indeed in many Western nations, but worldwide it is a significant medical problem. So we've developed a method of investigating all the genes in the bacterial genome. We've called this method transposon-directed insertion site sequencing, or TraDIS. Transposons are small fragments of DNA which will insert copies of themselves into other DNA, target DNA, and if they insert into a gene, they will inactivate the gene.
For this study, my colleagues generated a pool containing 1 million bacterial mutants in Salmonella typhi. So on average, there's a transposon insertion every 5 base pairs within the genome. If we see genes that do have transposons inserted within them, then it tells us that those genes are not essential for the cell's survival under those conditions. If, on the other hand, we never see a transposon inserted into a particular gene, it tells us that a functional copy of that gene is essential for the cell's survival. So we needed to develop an assay that would allow us to isolate the transposon from the rest of the genome in such a way that the fragments we generated could be sequenced on a next-generation sequencer. And this would allow us to pinpoint the insertion position. Because a next-generation sequencer can generate such a vast quantity of data, it means that we can survey the entire bacterial genome, every gene within that genome, for its necessity to the organism's survival in a single experiment.
Of the 4,538 genes of Salmonella typhi, we were able to conclude that 355 were essential. So we wanted to use the method to look at a specific medical problem. Salmonella typhi is carried in the gallbladder, which is the organ of bile storage. We therefore decided to look for genes required for bile tolerance. There are 170 genes which are likely to be involved in bile tolerance and Salmonella typhi. 30 of these previously are of unknown function. So by determining which genes are essential and which genes are required for bile tolerance, this allows us to identify targets in the bacterium that may be used for therapeutics or possibly for vaccines. New sequencing technologies are generating sequence data at a phenomenal rate. And then one of the next challenges for scientists is to determine ways of using that sequence data more efficiently and more effectively.